To our summer reading roundup, we have not one but two New York Times best-selling authors joining us with their top picks. Carly Fortune, author of Meet Me at the Lake, and Kylie Reed, author of Such a Fun Age. And it is so fun to have both of you with us here. Make sure you guys are following along with that QR screen, QR at the bottom of your screen. You can see the full list there. Welcome, you guys. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
It's such a pleasure having you. And I want to start, you know, we can't talk about summer reading without talking about rom-coms. I know I'm guilty. I love a good rom-com. So, Carly, what are you bringing on your vacation?
I have Talia Hibbert's Highly Suspicious and Unfairly Cute. I am a huge Talia Hibbert fan. This is her first rom-com for a YA audience. So if you have a young person in your life, or if you're like me and feel like you're 17 most of the time, this is the one to pick up. It is the story of two high school students who used to be best friends, and now they are mortal enemies until they are paired up on a wilderness survival course. And it's a really sweet story, and it tackles important stuff like teenage mental health, but it's funny too.
Mm-hmm. And Kylie, you're going with The Neighbor Favor by Christina Forrest. Talk to us about The Neighbor Favor.
The Neighbor Favor is so fun and so sweet, and I love books about books. It's two people who work in publishing, one who wants to work in children's publishing and one who is a fantasy writer. And they start a bit of an email flirtatious chain, and then he ghosts her out of nowhere, and that's all I'll say. It's very fun.
Such a tease.
Yes.
Let's talk about thrillers, because your pick takes us back in time a little bit. Tell us about it.
Yeah, I'm a big Ray Bradbury fan, and this is his first novel. It's called The Fix-Up Novel, which is a bunch of short stories made into a novel. And it's a bunch of humans settling on another planet. And I love when sci-fi still keeps emotions and human people at the forefront. It's a great read.
And your pick is actually someone that our book readers know and love already.
Yes, yes. So this is The Whispers by Ashley Audrain. And this, I'm not usually a thriller reader, but I could not put this book down. It follows the lives of four women after one of their children falls from his bedroom window under suspicious circumstances. And it's what I loved. It's about the secret lives of women and the ways we deal with the pressures of marriage and motherhood. It's very twisty.
Mm. And your pick for the 2023 breakout author is Annabelle Monahan, who has a new book called Same Time Next Summer. But both of you actually picked this one.
We did.
Yeah, it's so good.
It's
too good.
Right. It's so good. I think it's going to be everywhere this summer. It is like everything that I want in a summery read. It is an emotional love story. My chest hurt when I was reading it.
Wow.
Like I couldn't put it down. It's about a woman who goes to her Long Island family beach house to plan her wedding, only to fall face to face with her first love. And it goes back in time, so you get to see them fall in love, become friends, and you're trying to figure out what went wrong and what happened all those years ago.
And Kyla, who's your breakout author of the summer?
Breakout author is Jeff Boyd, who wrote The Weight. And it's a beautiful book. He's such a great author. It's about a young black man who's a musician in Seattle dealing with his belief in God and love and family. And I hate to say it as a pun, but it's a very heavy but wonderful read, The Weight. It's great.
Now, things that may be a little less heavy. You can't talk about summer reading without talking about those essential beach reads, those page turners that you can get to. So, what are you recommending that we take a look at as we hit the beach this summer?
My favorite read lately has been Nora Ephron's Heartburn. Of course, we know her essays, but this is one of her only novels. It is amazing, and it's a book about a woman who is 7 months pregnant when her husband cheats on her, which does not sound very uplifting, but I promise you, it is a great read. It's an even better listen, though, because Meryl Streep does the audible, and unsurprisingly, she's very good.
And that's good at the beach. That way you don't even have to worry about sand getting in your pages.
Exactly.
I'm curious, as writers, how much time you all actually spend reading.
Not as much as I'd like.
I'm with Carly on that one. Not as much, but audibles do make it very easy. And so I think writing and reading inspires my writing a lot of the time.
Yeah. Absolutely. We both have young children, so it's whenever we can fit it in. I love reading so much, but it's like, look at the page, look at the kid, look at the page, look at the kid.
That makes me feel better about the same five pages I've now been reading for a couple of weeks.
Yes, exactly.
Thank you both so much for being here and giving us so much.